Generally, in we're putting up the blue plaques for the suffragettes, which I know we talked about before we come on. So hopefully that celebrates 100 years of women's suffrage, and hopefully that will be a bit of a tourist attraction. We're doing four plaques. We've done the first one a couple of weeks ago for Minnie Turner. We ran a guest house took suffragettes down who suffered at the hands of the authorities and have been forced fed in prison and various things. So she ran a guest house in Victoria Road, Brighton, and we put a blue plaque up there. We opened that a couple of Sundays ago, which was really good. And we're going to do one for Elizabeth Robbins, who's no relation, although I tell everybody she is, because she's described as a beauty of her age and a towering intellect. So I tell everybody, the whole family's like that. And that's in Montpelier Crescent. She died in Brighton, American actress, very, very prominent in the age, and wrote plays and novels all about votes for women and women's suffrage. We're then doing one for Clementina Black, who is a local woman who fought for equal pay and was the first woman to take an amendment to the TUC, demanding equal pay for women way back before the turn of the 19th century. So very prominent figure. And then the final one we're hoping to do, I say final, it might be before one of the other two, is for the Women's Political and Social Union up at the clock tower. But that's where they met. So there's lots of connections. We're doing we're talking about perhaps a statue to another suffragette, Mary Clark, who's sometimes called the forgotten suffragette. She was Emily Pankhurst's sister, they called a day in 1910, November the 18th, Black Friday, when women protesting for votes up in London walked to Parliament and were attacked basically by the authorities, the police. And Mary Clark was attacked and arrested and suffered injuries, which eventually killed her on Christmas Day in 1910. But there's not a statue or a monument for her anywhere in the country. She stayed with Minnie Turner down in Brighton, so hopefully we're going to talk about doing something for her later on as well.
So
hopefully be a bit of a pull and recognise a sort of side of Brighton's history that's not greatly recognised.